These are five of my favorite iOS apps to hit the App Store during the month of July 2021. TimeWave lets you create timers that can go off in a chain. So if you set a 10-minute timer, for example, when it goes down to zero, you can set it so that another timer starts ticking down and just create a chain of these timers that act accordingly. It could be great for custom workouts where you can chain together exercises with breaks in between. You could create breathing exercises or focus timers to help you stay focused at work, but also incorporate a break in there somewhere. There's also, of course, the application for cooking. So you can set a time flow for each recipe you have. It's obviously gonna be different for whatever you're cooking. What's also neat is it can read out loud when a timer is done. Once again, great for cooking. And you can view a logbook of all your time waves for record keeping. So I just really wish the stock iOS app had this feature, but sadly it doesn't. So I guess that's where TimeWave comes in. Epilogue is a self-writing diary. It uses artificial intelligence to stitch together answers to questions that it asks you throughout the day to create a diary for you. Every day you have to answer about 6 questions unlocked at different times throughout the day. And when this is done, the AI will use your answers to write out a journal entry. As someone who's never really been able to stick to a journal app because it can be a bit time consuming, and honestly, I just don't really prioritize it, this app helps a lot because it'll send me questions throughout the day with notifications that make it a little bit harder to ignore, and it does much of the writing for me. So that's pretty cool. Not Boring Weather is a weather app that you can play like a game. You can tap to reveal all sorts of accurate real-time weather information. You can scroll to see what the weather will be like later in the day, and you can listen to the sounds of the weather that is going on around you, such as the rain, the thunder, and the wind. The wind actually blows based on actual wind speeds and direction, so that's kind of cool. There's also real moon phases. The text is big and readable. I love the animations. The sad part about this app, though, is that it does require a subscription, but you do get a week to mess around with it and see if it's worth committing to. 1 Hour Photo is a photo-taking app that applies unique cinematic filters to your photos, and it does so in a so-called magical way, as it requires you to wait an hour before you can see the results. They claim that this app will help you prevent yourself from getting distracted in the moment by reviewing your photos as they're taken. No, you can't do that here. You'll have to actually wait for the photos to digitally develop, so to speak. Can you cheat by manually setting the time an hour ahead over in the settings? Yeah, you can, but what's the fun in that? I mean, you do you, I won't judge, but I like how this app is designed. Let's just say that. GeoTrainer is an app that'll quiz your geography skills. You'll get to know the whole world with this app. The base version of the app includes 1 free quiz per region, but you can pay a one-time fee of $5 to unlock all the quizzes, which could totally be worth it. But you'll be able to be quizzed on the countries of the world, the capitals of the world, US states, German states, and more. It's a great app to have maybe in place of a game where you can just pick it up and start learning some geography. Maybe it's while filling up your tank of gas or waiting in line at the DMV. It's up to you to determine how you want to use this app, but I just really like it. Props to the developer for creating such a great educational app. So those are 5 of my favorite iOS apps to hit the App Store during the month of July 2021. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up. Maybe subscribe if you're brand new, and let us know which app is your favorite in a comment down below. As always, I'm Bo HD from Slash.tv. Hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you right back here in the next one. See ya.